नाउ टुडे वी विल स्टडी फियोफाइसी और ब्राउन एल्गी. द ब्राउन एल्गी और फियोफाइसी आर मल्टी सेलुलर एंड फाउंड इन मैरिन हैबिटेट्स. ओके, देयर इज नो यूनिसेलुलर ब्राउन एल्गी आर रिपोर्टेड. बट क्वेश्चन इज व्हाई दे आर कॉल्ड ब्राउन एल्गी. सो ब्राउन एल्गी कंटेन मैनी पिगमेंट्स लाइक क्लोरोफिल ए एंड सी एंड द ब्राउन फ्यूकोजैंथिन पिगमेंट. सो दिस फ्यूकोजैंथिन पिगमेंट्स मास्क द अदर पिगमेंट्स. सो ड्यू टू द प्रीडोमिनेंस और द ड्यू टू द प्रेजेंस ऑफ दिस फ्यूकोजैंथिन पिगमेंट्स दे अपीयर्स ब्राउन कलर. Now that this plant body of brown algae is usually attached to the substratum by a hold fast and a short stem like structure that is called the stipe and leaf like photosynthetic structure that is called the frond or lamina. Some examples now we will talk. For example, the sargassum found in the sea in the large area of the North Atlantic, and due to the presence of sargassum, that sea is also called the Sargasso Sea. Now, on the cellulose cell wall of brown algae, the cell wall is usually covered with phycocolloids, that is the alginic acid or algin, that protect the brown algae from drying, freezing on their exposure to air. The vegetative reproduction takes place by fragmentation in the algae. Now, the asexual reproduction in most of the brown algae is takes place by biflagellate zoospores that are pear-shaped and have two unequal laterally attached flagella. So this is the special character of the brown algae, that their zoospores are pear shaped having unequal laterally attached flagella. In many brown algae, the one celled globular unilocular sporangia developed that produce the biflagellate zoospores after meiosis. But in Ectocarpus, there will be the two types of sporangia, unilocular sporangia that produce zoospore by meiosis, and also there will be the multilocular sporangia that produce the zoospores in the Ectocarpus, but without meiosis. Now we talk about the Dictyota. In Dictyota, haploid non-motile tetraspores are produced after meiosis, which give rise to male and female plants. Sexual reproduction may be by fusion of flagellated motile similar gametes, that is the isogamous type of sexual reproduction, or due to the fusion of a small motile flagellated sperm and large stationary egg, that is the oogamous type of sexual reproduction. Now we will talk about the sexual reproduction in the Ectocarpus. Actually, Ectocarpus consists of two kinds of plants. Ectocarpus found in two kinds of plants that are similar in size and structure. The diploid form produces haploid spores called zoospores, and these spores develop to forms the haploid gamete. So now we will talking about the Ectocarpus. The Ectocarpus found in two kinds of plants found in similar size and structure. The diploid form produces haploid spores or haploid plants. These produces haploid gametes to produce a diploid zygote, and this zygote develops into a plant and completing the life cycle. While in the fucus, the diploid phase is dominant and the gametophytic generation is highly reduced. Okay, now you can see the life cycle here, life cycle of Ectocarpus plant. The Ectocarpus plant is the diploid plant. Diploid means the having two sets of chromosomes. So this Ectocarpus plant produces unilocular sporangia. This unilocular sporangia by meiosis produces the zoospores. By meiosis, zoospores are produced, means zoospores are haploid, having only one set of chromosomes. And now this zoospore developed to form the Ectocarpus plant. So this Ectocarpus plants are haploid. Okay. So there are two types of plants, diploid plants as well as haploid plants. So, and now this haploid Ectocarpus plants produces the gametes, male gametes and the female gametes, and these gametes now fuses to form the diploid zygote, and then this diploid zygote developed to form the Ectocarpus plant, that is the diploid plant. So this is the life cycle of Ectocarpus, showing the diploid and haploid isomorphic plants. The both plants are isomorphic, means similar in shape size, but the some plants are diploid while the some plants are the haploid. This diploid plants reproduces by the formation of zoospores, and the haploid plants reproduces by the formation of gametes. Means this is the gametophytic and this one is the sporophytic. Beside this process, in Ectocarpus, plurilocular sporangia is also produced, and this in the plurilocular or multilocular sporangia, zoospores are produced but without meiosis division, means zoospores are also diploid, and then this zoospore developed to form Ectocarpus plant. So this Ectocarpus produces two types of sporangia, unilocular sporangia as well as multilocular sporangia. In unilocular sporangia, zoospores are produced by meiosis, while in the multilocular or plurilocular sporangia, zoospores are produced without meiosis, means the zoospores are diploid, and from this diploid zoospores, the Ectocarpus plant developed, that is the diploid plant. Now we see the life cycle of fucus. In fucus, it's showing the highly reduced gametophytic haploid stage and the dominant diploid stage. The fucus plant is the diploid plant found in the nature, this fucus plant. And now this diploid plant produces the male reproductive organ, that is antheridia, and the female reproductive organ, that is the oogonia. Both are diploid. Now in these antheridia and oogonia, the gametes are produced by the meiosis cell division, that is the sperms and eggs, and now these gametes fuses during fertilization to form the diploid zygote, and then diploid zygote developed to form the fucus plant. So now here you see that their diploid generation is dominant, while the haploid generation includes only these gametes. Only these gametes are the haploid in the life cycle of fucus, and the other all stages of life cycle is the diploid stage. So this shows the diplontic type of life cycle, and this condition also found in the higher plants. So here we learned that in the algae, there be mainly the gametophytic generation is the dominant generation, but in the fucus, the sporophytic generation is the dominant generation. Thank you.